Hello and a big welcome to all of you. Now you have already gone through one of our video which spoke about strengths. Let us also see the flip side of it and discuss our weaknesses too. A very dicey question, a question which makes us vulnerable, and let's deep dive and see as to what we can do best in terms of protecting our weakness or portraying our weakness the right way. Being asked about your weaknesses in an interview is intimidating. After all, you are there to show them how capable you are, not to talk about what you are bad at. But what are your weaknesses is a question commonly asked at the interview, frequently paired with what are your strengths. So be sure to prepare for both. Answering well requires walking a tightrope. If you don't talk about anything that sounds like a plausible weakness, you come across as disingenuous or worse, deluded as to your lack of shortcomings. But if you are little too honest or if your weakness is a critical one, you risk sabotaging your interview. Unsurprisingly, not many candidates answer this question well. I know for sure. This presents you with an opportunity to stand out if you practice and prepare well. It can work in your favor. A good answer shows that you are self-aware and be able to critically analyze your skills. It shows that you are willing. It also shows that you are willing to address your weaknesses and that you can remain calm under pressure. Now, let's see and how we can tackle this tricky question and turn our greatest weakness into our greatest interview strength. How? Interviewers are looking to discover your weak points to see how you will address them. Why do interviewers ask this question at all? It does seem a little perverse when candidates are doing their best to make a good impression, the interviewer asks them to talk themselves down. However, interviewers can gain a huge amount of insight from this simple question or a variant of it. This question is popularly primarily because of its effectiveness at getting the candidate to think deeply about themselves. More specifically, interviewers might want to ask this question to assess your character and personality. To gauge your level of self-awareness and ability to reflect on your skills and any gaps if you have. To check that you don't have any critical flaws that might affect your ability to perform in the role. To see if you are willing to work on your weaknesses. To test your ability to maintain composure under pressure. Different ways of asking the weaknesses question. While this question is often asked outright, it can also take a variety of forms. Make sure you know that the interviewer is really asking so you don't get caught up. Here are a few of the other ways it can be phrased. Mind this. What would your employer or colleague describe as your biggest weakness? Which of your current tasks or duties do you find most challenging? Which of these roles, tasks or duties would you struggle with the most? Have any difficulties or issues arisen in your current role? What is the biggest regret you'll have on leaving your current job? Is there any area of your skill set that you feel still needs work? Tell me about a time when you let your team down. While each of these questions and many more maybe are all asking a similar question, you don't want to come across as robotic, like you have prepared this answer purely by rote. Understand that they are asking for your weaknesses, but take note of how exactly they posed this question. Tailor your response accordingly and it will come across as off the cuff, confident and fluent. Being able to adapt to the questions you are being asked is an important interview skill. It not only demonstrates that you can deliver a good answer, but that you can think on your feet and have good communication skills. The best way to prepare for questions about your weaknesses is by doing as much practice as possible. How to assess and select a weakness? This is a million-dollar question. How do you pick a good weakness to talk about in your interview? The weakness you choose should ideally be 1. Not fundamental to the job. You probably won't get far if you are applying for an accounting job and your weakness is that you are awful with numbers. Relevant. You should choose a weakness relating to relevant professional competencies. Answering with something like "I just don't do enough exercises" sounds like you are dodging the question. Fixable. One of the most important parts of answering this question is to get across the idea that you actively work on your weaknesses. This means that your weakness needs to be something that you could feasibly improve through personal effort. One of the ways to choose a relevant weakness is to research the role thoroughly. Knowing What the employer is looking for is the best way to avoid pitfalls and turn the question to your advantage. For instance, if the position requires lots of teamwork and regular interaction with management, a good weakness to use might be that you find it difficult to stay motivated in roles where you feel isolated or those in which you can't learn from those around you. That's still a genuine weakness, but it's one that's largely negated by the role you have applied for. It also gets across the implication that you like the way the company works and would feel motivated here. It's important that for each weakness you prepare to talk about, you have a relevant example ready to help you describe your weakness and demonstrate how you attempted to overcome it. Is overthinking a weakness? Overthinking can be viewed as both a strength and weakness. It is therefore not a strong answer to give them when asked about the weaknesses. In some respects, someone that overthinks can be perceived to be unsure of themselves and their decision making. You may be delaying your decision making because you are scared of facing your consequences of your decisions. This weakness would or could be probably concerning to an interviewer. So if you really want to mention this at interview, make sure you show evidence of self-reflection and mention the steps you are taking to address this or how you have begun to use it to achieve a positive outcome. Overthinkers could also be seen as careful perfectionists that take time to consider all aspects of decision so they don't miss anything. This is not really a weakness. It may be seen by the interviewer to be a veiled attempt at presenting a positive as a negative. Some sample answers. To help you prepare for your interview, here are certain answers. Example number one, you are applying for an analyst position, largely working with numbers and idea or data. I don't have much experience working directly with clients, so my client-facing communication skills definitely need some work. I'm much more comfortable digging deep into the data and providing the analysis rather than talking it through with a client. However, I realize that experience working with clients directly would be a big help to the way I present my analysis, so I'm very keen to improve that aspect. Now, this is an answer that's honest and shows a good degree of critical self-reflection. It's a weakness that isn't critical to the role, but the candidate recognizes the ways that fixing their weaknesses would help them in the area they are already strong in. This answer also manages to sneak in a strength, digging deep into data and providing analysis of it. Number two, a more generic weakness that can be used for any role with evidence of proactivity. Answer. At the beginning of my career, I found that I was overwhelmed with the level of work expected of me. Scheduling everything was a big issue for me when I dropped the ball on some projects because I wasn't able to give them my proper focus. However, I attended a number of time management seminars and have found my workload much more manageable since then. I'm continuing to work on it. Here, the candidate explains a weakness of theirs that could be a serious problem, but immediately shows that they have already been taking significant steps towards fixing it and they have made good progress so far. That comes across as genuine and shows that the candidate is proactive and self-reflective. Number three, a weakness that isn't critical and that is easily fixed. Answer, in the past, I've tended to want to complete one project in its entirety before moving on to another. Of course, that can cause problems in a busy workplace. I know that in the future, I need to be more comfortable switching focus when it's needed. Now, this is an acceptable version of the I am just too much of perfectionist answer. It's a problem a lot of people can relate to, as it's only natural that we want to see our work completed and followed through before switching focus. You'll probably have the interviewer agreeing with you. Again, though, it shows some self-reflection by recognizing the issues that this approach can cause. Of course, any answer you give will need to be specific to both you and the role. Don't make something up. You'll come across as disingenuous and might not be able to handle any follow-up question. STAR technique. The STAR method is a fantastic approach for all interview questions. It's a technique you should be familiar with and practice. It's a way of structuring any example-based response you give that ensures all the key components are there. For example, situation. Give the context of the example. What was the company and the project? What was the client? Were you working in a team? Task. Move into the specifics and describe your role in the project and what your goal was. Action. Describe the actions that you took towards your goal. This should be specifically about your contribution, not the teams. Result. Talk about the outcome of the actions you took. If you can slip some numbers in here to make things more concrete. While this method would typically be used when talking about your positive traits and achievements, after all, that's mostly what you want to be doing in an interview, it's still useful when talking about your weaknesses. It helps keep your examples concise and engaging. The interviewer can easily follow your scenarios from start to finish, getting all the important details along the way. Always keep the STAR method in mind when describing your weaknesses in an interview. Answer to avoid, what are your weaknesses is a minefield of a question, and there are plenty of answers that really won't do. Learn what these answers are and what they have in common so you can be sure you never commit any interview sins. Giving a weakness that is actually a strength. I'm just such a perfectionist. I don't like substandard effort, so I make sure all my work is perfect. This might mean that I work too hard, but it's worth it to me because it's so annoying finishing work that's less than perfect. This candidate shows no humility and, more importantly, no evidence or self-reflection. It will be clear to the interviewer that they are trying to dodge the question while at the same time overselling themselves. Giving a weakness that reflects a bad attitude. My weakness is that I just hate getting up in the morning. I snooze the alarm like 10 times before finally dragging myself up. I look forward to the weekends so I can have a lie in without worrying about getting up for work. Almost no one likes getting up early in the morning. This is not a weakness that reveals anything about you professionally. Moaning about it won't earn you much sympathy, especially when it implies that you might be late to work when your penchant for snoozing gets the better of you. Furthermore, this answer shows no willingness or proactive drive to resolve the issues. Giving a weakness that has little or no bearing on your professional competencies. I'm scared of dogs. I got bitten by one of the child and now I can't stand being around them. Sometimes it makes it quite awkward when I have to meet someone who I know has a dog. Unless you are applying for a job working with animals, this weakness is just irrelevant. For the purpose of this question, save your childhood traumas for the therapist. It doesn't tell the interviewer anything and will either sound like you are oversharing or that you are dodging the question, refusing to answer the question. I don't really have any weaknesses. To be honest, in my last role, I performed really well and can't see where I could have improved. Everyone has weaknesses, everyone from the fresh graduate to most experienced CEO. Giving the answer either paints you as dishonest or deluded, and neither of those are positive traits. It also displays a critical lack of self-reflection and can easily come across as arrogant. In addition, avoid very vague or general answers. They don't give any relevant information. These will tell the interviewer that you can't think on your feet. If your answers isn't honest, doesn't reflect on your skills and your gaps, and doesn't demonstrate a willingness to improve, then it needs some work. I'm sure by doing this, that sounds more like a positive. Give me an actual weakness. So I'm more than happy to give you a great insight, a deeper insight as to addressing your weaknesses this time. So the next time when you come to this question, you will be damn good, happy to answer it. Best prepared, best wishes. Thank you.